Hi, I'm Matt from Duo Security. In this video, I'm going to show you how to protect SSH servers with Duo Network Gateway. Duo Network Gateway, also known as DNG, allows you to remotely access your SSH servers over HTTPS. Before watching this video, please read the documentation located at duo.com/docs/DNG. In particular, read the Protect SSH Servers with Duo Network Gateway section. You can group access to a set of servers, and after you have authenticated, you will be able to connect to all servers in that group. You can group servers by level of security or by departments within your organization. Each group can have its own policies set via the Duo Admin panel. Learn more about policies at duo.com/docs/policy. Note also that this configuration supports inline self-service enrollment and the Duo prompt. Before configuring DNG to protect SSH servers, complete the necessary prerequisites. Install and configure Duo Network Gateway for your environment. There is an installation overview video provided on the documentation page. Identify the SSH servers you want to protect and make sure that DNG is able to communicate locally with each server over the SSH ports they are configured to use. Create a public DNS record related to your set of SSH servers and point it to the DNG server. This DNS record must be different from the Duo Network Gateway's DNS record and from your SSH servers' records, even if your SSH servers have a public DNS record already. For example, if the group of servers you are protecting is for your engineering team, you could create a public CNAME DNS record of engineering-ssh.example.com and point it to the DNG. Finally, obtain an SSL certificate for your external URL from a commercial certificate authority, also known as a CA, using the fully qualified external DNS name of your external URL as the common name. For example, this could be engineering-ssh.example.com. This secures the connection between your external users and the DNG server. You can also generate a free, automatically renewing certificate from Let's Encrypt during setup. In this video, we will use Let's Encrypt. Note that port 80 must be open in order to retrieve the Let's Encrypt certificate. Now create the DNG SSH Servers application in Duo. Log in to the Duo Admin panel and navigate to Applications. Click Protect an Application and locate Duo Network Gateway SSH Servers in the Applications list. Click Protect this application. You are taken to your new Applications Properties page, which contains your integration key, secret key, and API hostname. You will need this information later. You can adjust additional settings for your Duo Network Gateway application at this time. For example, you may change the application's name from the default value, enable self-service, or assign a group policy. You can also come back and change the application's policies and settings after you finish setup. Whenever you do update any settings, be sure to click the Save Changes button when done. Next, publish the SSH servers via DNG. Navigate to the Duo Network Gateway Admin Console. Click the Applications link on the left-hand side of the screen. On the Applications page, click Add New and select SSH Servers from the drop-down options. You will be taken to a new page. Under Configure 2FA, enter the integration key, secret key, and API hostname from the SSH Servers application you created earlier in the Duo Admin panel. Scroll down to the External URL Settings section. In the External URL field, enter the hostname of the external URL DNS record for your SSH servers that you created as part of the prerequisites. The external URL is where users' computers will communicate with the Duo Network Gateway. A group of SSH servers can be protected behind an external URL. If you were going to supply your own SSL certificate, you would select Provide My Own Certificate next to Certificate Source and configure it here. As we are going to use a certificate generated by Let's Encrypt, we will select Generate a Certificate on Save. read the terms of service for Let's Encrypt and check the box if you agree to them. In the Session Duration field, specify the maximum user session duration in minutes for an external URL. Users must re-authenticate to the Duo Network Gateway the next time they attempt a connection when the limit is reached. This will not close currently open connections. The default is 480 minutes, or 8 hours. Scroll down to the SSH Servers section. Multiple SSH servers can be protected behind an external URL. Once a user authenticates through the external URL, they can access any of the SSH servers behind the external URL without having to authenticate again. Users will need to re-authenticate on the next login attempt after their session has expired based on the session duration setting described previously. Users will still need to locally authenticate to the SSH servers.
In the first field, enter a hostname with wildcards, an IP address, a range of IP addresses, or a CIDR block related to the internal SSH servers you want to protect. In the second field, enter the port or ports that the servers are listening on for SSH connections.
You may enter a single port or a range of ports. You can also specify multiple ports or multiple ranges of ports by separating them with commas.
Additional fields will appear below the first one as you add more.
Wildcards will not match subdomains. Wildcards will be used to match domain names, not IP addresses. Once you have filled in all the required fields, click Add SSH Servers.
The application will save and you will be brought back to the Applications page. Click the entry for your SSH server. You will see a section at the top of the page called SSH Client Configuration. This contains SSH client configuration information that your users will need to configure Duo Connect.
Using the Duo Network Gateway to protect SSH servers requires a small software install on the user's computer. We support 64-bit operating systems for the following platforms: Windows, macOS 10.11 through 10.13, and most Linux distributions. You and your users can learn how to install and configure Duo Connect using the Duo Connect User's Guide available at guide.duo.com/duoconnect. Note that they will also need the configuration information from the DNG admin console.
In this video, we will show you how to set up Duo Connect for macOS. Open a browser and navigate to guide.duo.com/duoconnect. Navigate to the macOS Clients section. Click the link to download the latest Duo Connect installer. Launch it. Click Continue. Leave the installation folder as the default. Click Install. When prompted, enter your username and password. Click Close. Move the installer package to the trash. Open Terminal on your Mac. Open /.ssh/config with a text editor. Copy and paste the Duo Connect connection string from the DNG admin console. Replace the bracketed text with the hostname of the SSH server. Save the file and exit. Test your setup by attempting to connect to a server as you normally would. A browser window will pop up, prompting you to enter your organizational username and password. After successfully entering your primary credentials, you will need to complete Duo two-factor authentication or enroll in Duo. As our user has already enrolled in Duo and activated Duo Mobile, we can select Send me a push, Call me, or enter a passcode to complete authentication. Click Send me a push to send a Duo push notification to your smartphone. On your smartphone, open the notification, check the contextual information to confirm the login is legitimate, and approve it. The next page instructs you to close the browser tab and to return to your SSH client. You will be connected to the SSH server and can then continue with logging in to the remote server like you normally would. At this point, you may disable direct external access to the SSH server so that all users must complete authentication via the Duo Network Gateway. You have successfully protected SSH servers with DNG.